the Combo Plus is absolutely eating this part, like no problem at all. I'm kind of impressed. All right, guys, today we're scanning this 1-2-3 block. Now, if you're a machinist, you're very familiar with these. It's a machined perfect block at 1 inch by 2 inch by 3 inches long. And it's used for calibrating CNC devices and things like that and getting exact measurements. But today, it's a great example for the FreeScan Combo Plus and the laser modes and infrared modes to show you exactly how these scanners will reflect and react with different surfaces. You know, one of the things we always talk about is black absorbs all light, so it's not reflecting light back to triangulate the data points with a 3D scanner. So the lasers, the intensity of that light manages to get enough on black surfaces. The same goes for reflective and metallic surfaces where it's scattering and reflecting all the light back, and so that can also cause issues. So today, we're gonna scan this with the Combo Plus, the FreeScan Combo Plus, to see how well the blue lasers pick up all these different types of surfaces, and for funsies, we might just do the infrared mode too to show you that. Now, the way we've accomplished this is by, online, we found BLK 3.0, which is advertised as the darkest, most light absorbing paint on the market. It's the closest thing that we could find that you can buy to Vanta Black. So this absorbs a ton of, it's blacker than any other paint that we could find. It really is an interesting thing. Now let me show you a couple other things to give you an example. So these are a few other parts that we coated in this black. And as you can see, they are very dark. It's a startling difference compared to your standard black spray paint. So BLK 3.0, very cool stuff. And for the reflective, we used Mirror, which is advertised as the most reflective metallic paint you can possibly buy. It is literally like a mirror. So with these two things, we can do some really cool tests with the blue laser and infrared on the FreeScan Combo Plus. So again, this is how we make our living. We sell this equipment so that we can make content to show you before you buy exactly what you're gonna get. On that note, let's go ahead and start scanning. Okay, so let's go ahead and open up the software here. I'm gonna go into laser mode to start. All right, so we're gonna go ahead and select new project group. Make sure you're in the right folder and name the project 1-2-3 surfaces. Call it that. That's gonna create the folder and everything else. Now, I could scan markers, that's an option. Most of the time I don't need to or want to. It can add to the angles that you can scan from. For this, we really don't need to do that. So I go straight to scan mesh, and then I have three options for lasers. 50 lines on the Combo Plus, 26 on the regular combo, or 7 lines for high detail, or single line for downhole and getting into little areas. So we're just gonna stick to the 50 laser lines for right now, so we get that speed and coverage to make this go nice and quick. And next we have normal and reflective mode. So we'll test both of those on this object, and of course the exposure. This is the brightness of the lasers, and so we're gonna use auto exposure for this environment. Now, my detail, I'm gonna go ahead and just do 0.5 millimeters because that'll give me a lot of points really fast, and we'll see how well it actually picks up the geometry. And lastly, we've got the data quality indicator. That one's always good, and we'll leave everything else as is. So then I just come over here and I hit the button on the back and I start scanning. Oops, I did not use the auto exposure, so we'll just see how it does at that brightness. My gosh, this is working much better than expected. Cool, let's check out that data. So as we can see, it had basically no trouble. Now we can tell that I feel like the edges on this side are a little bit rougher. So let's figure out which side is that. It's almost no difference, but there is a little bit more issues, I suppose, on the reflective side compared to the black. So now let's go see what auto exposure wants. So I'm gonna delete my scan, clear all, go ahead and do auto exposure, keeping it on normal mode. And I will go ahead, you know, I felt like that went too fast, so I'm gonna go down to 0.3 millimeter resolution. Okay, let's do this again. Go boom, auto exposure is calibrating. And we have success. Now I'm going to just scan around. And once again, we've got the full object. This Combo Plus, I will say, is significantly faster than the original Combo. I didn't expect it to be that much faster, but I mean, you're getting 3 million something points compared to the 1.8 before, so it makes sense. But let's check out that data. What have we got? Okay, so higher point resolution, we got more data overall. Again, we're on the shiny side over here. You can tell it's having a harder time with it versus the black side over here. It just looks overall smoother. Same on this side, I'd say that's pretty clear. So you can see a lot more texture over there than this side. And then in the middle, it's kind of an in-between. I mean, this is working pretty darn well. I'll delete that data. You know, so Kyle just brought up a great point. Looking at this part, the paint actually does have some texture. I mean, you can barely see in that macro shot there. The black paint is pretty smooth and flat. Obviously, the machine metallic surface is very flat. And then the edge of the reflective right here, you can see. Let me see if we can get a good reflection on the camera. Okay, so that's a good observation. I think in the data, it still was a little more bumpy than the actual object, but sometimes that's hard to say. So let's try reflective mode with auto exposure. Again, faster than it could possibly go. I might even go down in resolution. Very good, let's check this out. We are looking at a little, I mean, it's close. It's definitely more textured over here. I don't think that's necessarily the paint texture. But I mean, overall, the Combo Plus is absolutely eating this part, like no problem at all. I'm kind of impressed, very impressed. Let's do one high resolution test, and then we'll switch over to IR to see how that scatters the light. All right, down to 0.1. Okay, so this automatically switched to 7 lines for high detail, and I'm gonna do auto exposure, and we'll see what kind of a difference that makes. But so far, this has been not a challenge at all. Now, one thing to note is when you're on 7 lines, you have to hold the scanner a lot closer to the part, which also means you need more markers around the part because the viewing window is much smaller. So at this point, I don't have enough markers on my table. So I'm gonna add 3 or 4 markers, and I'm gonna add these markers in the form of pyramid markers, which we include with every scanner we sell. It's one of those special things we do here at Vision Miner. We give you not only the scanner markers, but usually a couple other accessories just as a thank you for buying from us. So I got more markers. Let's see if I can just keep it going right where we were. That's one of the things I love about these scanners. A lot of the times you don't have to pause the scan to add more markers. I can just add more markers and I'm ready to go. Okay, I gotta get closer to this. And I'm gonna do a view lock. Since it's really zoomed in, I'm gonna look at my object and then hit view lock. So now I can just look at my part and watch the laser lines go. One of the things to notice with this is we went from 0.5 to 0.3 and now at 0.1. And each time it does take exponentially longer to gather full point cloud density at that resolution. So obviously more points, more time. All right, I'd say that's pretty good. Let's check out our data. It's looking great. It really is. Let's look at this top surface. It looks no different almost between the right and the left side and the center. So those lasers are going in and they're reflecting back and it's showing you exactly the geometry of the part. No problem for the blue lasers. Fascinating. Now, let's switch over to infrared mode and see if there's a difference there. So I'm gonna go to modes, confirm, delete all my other data. I'm gonna select IR mode and new project group. And I'll do 123 surfaces underscore IR to make a new folder. Then I'll do object, small objects, hybrid mode so that it uses the markers on the turntable for alignment in addition to the geometry. And we'll just go with the default resolution of 0.2 millimeters. Okay, so now I can set my working distance, which is important for how far away I need to hold the scanner in infrared mode. And as always, I'm gonna keep the data quality indicator and we'll turn off view lock for this one. So I'm gonna go default on everything, but I am going to increase my working distance up to 250 millimeters so that I have a little bit more space to scan from. And as you can see, the highly reflective side is not even getting picked up. And it'd be the same in structured light. It's just scattering all that light around. Let me zoom in for you here so you can really see. It can't see the reflective side. It's doing okay on the black because infrared light will reflect off of darker objects. So that's one of the reasons it's really good for hair scanning and people scanning. The infrared doesn't have trouble with that. If you tried this with normal structured light on something like the Pro HD right here, it would struggle a lot more. And that's when scanning sprays come in. There are these disappearing scanning sprays that we also carry, known as A-Sub. And they are basically all different white matte spray paints, but they disappear after a few hours. So the blue is 2 to 4 hours, the orange is anywhere from 24 to 36 hours. And there's also some other versions for metrology grade scanning that are down to a micron thick. So really cool stuff. Let's check out this data. So yeah, we can immediately tell that it didn't pick up anything on that side. Now let's clean up this data a little bit. So I'm gonna grab 1, 2, 3 markers, create the plane, and now I'm just gonna bump that up just a hair, apply. Now we can look at our part a little more clearly. So yeah, almost no data on the reflective side. And let's go ahead and generate the point clouds. All right, here we go. So these are basically, we've got the points all in there, but it did not capture anything hardly. And you can see also very clear as day, the dark side over here, and then the metallic and shiny side on the right. So the dark side's right here, and then this whole area is machined metal, and this whole area is highly reflective metallic paint. Yeah, you can even see right there, that's about the cutoff for the black right there in the center. And then it immediately gets a lot more bumpy and whatnot. So let's go ahead and mesh this real quick, see what it's gonna look like. We'll go no filter, or just, we'll go standard filters and see what it does. Cool. Okay, so I think it's very, very clear that we can see the blue lasers not only outperform what we expected, but they do handle the reflective surfaces far better than anything else. The infrared, the structured light, etc., struggle with this kind of a surface. And frankly, the lasers absolutely knocked it out. So just to show you guys the power of blue laser scanning, if you've ever scanned and had trouble with reflective surfaces, glossy stuff, anything like that, the blue lasers really, really do make a difference, especially with something like the FreeScan Combo Plus, which is a professional scanner. Now, if you're interested in this scanner or any of the other scanners, and you want a live demo or you got some questions or anything like that, reach out, give us a call. We are here to help. This is what we do every day. We specialize in high temperature, advanced material 3D printing, as well as 3D scanning, metrology, and reverse engineering. So we got all the software, hardware, and packages to get you and your business set up and ready to go. So if you're interested, give us a call, shoot us an email. We're always here to help. On that note, leave a comment down below. What do you want to see us scan? What kind of stress tests or versus tests could we do that would help inform you and give you valuable information? Let me know down in the comments below. And if you liked it, hit that like button. Thank you guys so much for watching. Have a positive rest of your day. I'll see you on the next video.